She means it, Bea. Any more crusading and that's the end of the stir.
Look, Mr. Faulkner, I am no crusader, but I hate the way you make it sound like a dirty word. Now, you've made your point, and so has Mrs. Davidson.
What do you mean?
You must have got a big kick out of confiscating all those newspapers and showing everyone what a super efficient person you are.
Come on, that's my job.
You could have let a few copies slip through. No one would have known.
I would have known. Look, I help you all I can, but I'm not going to start jeopardizing my job or go against my conscience.
Conscience? You're just like all the rest that rave on about helping us. When it comes down to the nitty-gritty and you have to lay yourself on the line for someone who's given a raw deal, you chicken out. Conscience! I don't know how any of you sleep nights.
My Uncle Jed always said he only wanted one thing in life, and that was to have a hinge put in the top of his head.
A hinge?
Well, a hinge.
What for?
Well, sometimes people drink his drink and it'll blow the top of their skulls clean off. Now, he didn't want to wake up in the morning with a hangover and go looking for his, did he?
All right, Donahue, get him in.
Here, and say a prayer before your first mouthful.
Everybody, this is Jackie Donahue.
Right.
Hello.
What's up with you? You look like you've seen a ghost.
I have. That's her. That's the girl in the taxi.
What?
That's the one. That's the bitch that's responsible for me being back in here. That's her.
Pretty cool little number, isn't she?
Yeah. I'll soon sort that out. Hello. Remember me?
No. Should I?
Well, the last time I saw you, I was driving a taxi and you were in a spot of bother.
I take a lot of taxis. I don't remember the drivers.
Hmm. Well, how about the drivers that do time for you? Do you remember them?
I don't know what you're talking about. You're getting me mixed up with someone else.
What's going on?
I don't know.
Hey, Brian, what's got your knickers in a knot?
Yeah, come on, Jude, fill us in.
This is the little bitch I was telling you about. I saved her from a drunk in my taxi, so to thank me, she rolled and emptied his wallet and left me to take the blame.
Look, she's crazy. I've never seen this old bat before in my life.
Watch your mouth. You're talking about a friend of mine.
I don't know who she's after, but it's not me. I haven't done nothing.
Well, you're going to do something now. You're going to tell the screws and the governor and the whole bloody world, if necessary, that you're the one that they want and get me out of here.
Leave me alone.
Maybe she needs a little persuasion.
Yeah, let me do it. I'm real good at persuading.
No, no. Something I got to handle myself.
I don't like having to restrict the women's freedom, but sometimes they give me no choice.
Well, now the papers are confiscated. Hopefully that's an end to it.
Let's hope so. Oh, what about the Donahue girl? Any problems there?
No, not so far. She's very green, though.
Yes, far too green to be sharing a cell with Gaffney. I noticed you've put them together.
Couldn't see any reason why not.
You know that in the past, I have always tried to give a woman serving her first sentence a cell of her own.
Yes, well, there weren't any single cells available. Carol Lewis was allotted at the last one.
Oh? Well, then it should be quite a simple matter to transfer Donahue into the single cell and put Lewis in with Gaffney. Lewis seems to be able to give as good as she gets. Would you arrange that transfer tonight, please?
Whatever you say. Night. Look, I'm not going to hurt you. I don't blame you for running out, especially since you didn't know they were going to pin the whole thing on me. But now that you do know, you should do something about it.
Look, I don't know what you're talking about. I keep telling you, you're making a mistake.
Listen to me, Jackie. You owe me one. You would have been in big trouble with that drunk if I hadn't helped you. You can't just turn your back on me.
Look, I'm sorry. Really, I am. But I've got to look after myself. I've only got 2 weeks to serve in this hall. I'd be mad to lumber myself with 2 years.
Well, I'm doing 2 years for an assault and robbery I didn't commit. Okay, maybe I can do nothing about that. But they are looking for my accomplice, and we both know who that is.
What's going on in here?
She was just filling me in on things.
Get your things together. You're moving to a single cell. Don't argue with me. Just do as you're told. Come on, Branch. You can get a move on. Sure, Donahue can manage on her own.
Yeah, I bet she can.
No good, huh?
No. I'm back to square one. You know, when I saw that girl, I really thought I was going to get out of this place once and for all. Huh, I should have known better.
But she can't just keep denying everything.
Can't she? I mean, she's after number one. You can't blame her for that, I guess. The only thing is, I don't know how I'm going to tell Laurie I'm back inside. I mean, what's it going to do to
her? Oh, come on, love.
Please, Bea, leave me alone.
Poor old Jude. She always gets the dirty end of the stick.
Yeah.
Look, all we've got to do is put the wind up little Miss Innocence so she'll spill her guts to the screws and get Jude off the hook.
Oh, God, Marg, are you so subtle? What do you suggest? Thumb screws?
How about a good swift kick to the head? I'll do it if you like, seeing as how she's in my cell.
There must be some way of pressuring her without landing ourselves in the pound.
You lot gone bloody soft or something.
Oh, why don't you just leave your mouth in neutral and give us all a rest? This is Judy's business. We're not having anyone unless she asks us to.
Lewis, go and pack your things. You're moving in with Gaffney.
Tonight?
Now. Move it.
Hey, that's great.
Yeah, I was getting a bit lonely on the air.
I'll help you pack if you like.
Okay.
And a gin and tonic. Okay. Well, that's everyone except me. Won't be tea.
Hi, gorgeous.
Oh, hello.
Where's our old mate, the Admiral? Still up at the fun factory.
Steve. No, he's finished for the day. I think he's working on his boat.
I figured. Scotch and soda, please. Well, what have you been up to? Anything exciting?
Oh, very. I've just spent half the day at the dentist with a rotten toothache.
Rather you than me. Mm. I can't stand the dentist. Devout coward, I'm afraid.
Yeah, me too. And I've got to go back tomorrow and have the darn thing out.
Oh. Pity old Steve didn't come in for a drink. I was having to get a look at the latest copy of The Stir, hot off the presses.
Oh, well, I don't know about hot, but I've got a rather creased copy in my bag you can look at if you like.
Well, don't keep me in suspenders. You know I'm the soul of discretion. I just want to read it for a giggle.
Okay.
There you go. I reckon we're going to get on real well. Pity I won't get a chance to sort out that Donahue bitch, but...
Judy a good mate of yours, is she?
Right. Nah, not really. Reckon she's a bit of a joke. But see, I can't stand two-timing little sneaks who do the dirty on you and then try and snivel their way out of it.
Like Donahue, you mean?
Oh, Donahue's not the first. I've seen plenty of them. There's two types you don't give the time of day to in this joint, and that's one of them.
What's the other?
Screws have got it in for you.
Must be interesting.
Sure is. Pretty exciting stuff. Not every day we get the lowdown on the inside.
Oh, so is this going to end up in the dispatch too?
Are you kidding? If we printed something like this without corroboration, we'd be sued. Maybe even end up in Wentworth.
Oh, hardly. Wentworth's a women's prison, remember?
Well, maybe your B. Smith could give me some hints on journalism. Anyway, I better be going. My editor's still looking for a man bites dog headline. See ya.
Hey, but you still got my paper.
What? Oh, look. I really appreciate your lending it to me. Here, have a drink on me. So long, I've got to run.
But I haven't read it yet.
Hi. What do you want? Look, you better get out of here or I'll yell for help.
Oh, I wouldn't say that if I were you.
I wouldn't even think it.
We have a rule in here, kid. Nobody dobs anyone into the screws. You see, that's lagging.
And laggers don't last too long around here.
What do you mean?
What she means is we have our own rules here in Wentworth and our own way of dealing with people who break them.
You're trying to scare me.
No, Jackie, you're so wrong. I'm trying to help you. And that's why you're going to go to Davo and clear Judy, because we all want to stay healthy, don't we, Helen?
Sure do.
But I told you, she's made a mistake.
No way. Jude just doesn't make those sort of mistakes.
Funny thing about the women in here, they really look after people they like. And nobody is better liked than Judy. Some pretty pretty unpleasant things can happen to anyone who upsets a mate.